Jai Hind. Welcome to another video by Study Funda. Today, I'll be explaining a very important aspect of SSB, that is the Personal Information Questionnaire. What is the Personal Information Questionnaire? PIQ is a document that is similar to the curriculum vitae or your resume that you fill for your corporate interviews. It has certain amount of information related to yourself, your place of residence, your background, related to your family, your education, your height and weight, your sport involvement in sports activities, hobbies, extracurricular activities, and many other such information is enclosed in this document. Now, on your arrival on the very first day, every candidate is supposed to fill 3 copies of this personal information questionnaire. One copy goes to the interviewing officer, another copy is taken up by the psychologist, and there is a third copy that is kept as reserved. So this document basically creates an impression or an image about you in front of the interviewing officer and also to the psychologist. So this is one of the first impressions that you create to the panel of the SSB board. Now, there are certain very important aspects of how to fill this document. Ladies and gentlemen, this documentation has a lot of importance because you provide the information about your exposure till this particular time of your life. By exposure, I mean the kind of environment that you have grown up in, the kind of education that you have received, and your involvement in the surroundings around you through participation in extracurricular activities, sports, other events. So now let us take a look at the PIQ form. This is the first page of the PIQ form. Let us take every column and understand what are we supposed to fill in this. The first part is the service selection board, number and place. If you are going to Bhopal, there are several boards in it. The board number, that is 21 SSB, 22 SSB, you are supposed to fill it in this particular column. Then there is the batch number that is allotted to you at the time of the interview, and then there is the chest number also allotted at the time of the interview, and the UPSC number, which is basically your roll number for the examination or the entry that you are appearing in. Next comes name in capitals. So the name has to be written capital letters. Very important it is. Those of you whose handwriting is not appropriate or not that good, you can mention all the information in capital letters so as to ensure clarity about everything that is written. Next is father's name. The father's name, you should add a prefix before your father's name. Mr. As it is written here, Mr. Ketan Sharma. Then there, the fourth column, we have 3 pieces of information to be filled. Place of maximum residence. And the way it is supposed to be filled is mentioning place, comma, district, comma, state, and with the approximate population of the place. This information is similar for these 3 columns. The next is present residence, where you are currently residing. Then permanent residence, which is the place that you come from. In this case, it is Mathanel, Jhajjar, Haryana, with the approximate population of 2000. Now, whether this particular place of permanent residence is a district headquarter or not. In this case, it is not a district headquarter, so no has been written. Now, let us take a look at the next column, that is the fifth, in which state and district, which is self-explanatory, religion, whether SCST, OBC, mother tongue, date of birth. The date of birth has to be written in this particular format. In this case, it is 4/05/1996, and whether married, single or widowed. The next column relates to whether your parents are alive or not, and in this case it is the parents are alive. So the next column, everywhere the column that is not applicable to you, you have to write N/A. In the next, we see the C part of the sixth column, information regarding the family, father, mother, then elder brother, sister, younger brother, sister. So in this case, the family has father, mother and an elder sister. The education, the occupation and the income. As it has been seen, it is seen that in the case of mother, she is a homemaker, so she is not earning anything. So a dash has to be put over there. The next column is related to the educational record. In this, the education starting from matric, that is 10th standard, 10 plus 2, graduation, post-graduation. In this case, only the first year applicable. The post-graduation course is not applicable. So the name, full name of the institution. Now, in case you have to use, you have a bigger name, you can also use short forms which are generally understandable. Like Kendriya Vidyalaya, short form can be KV. The board or university, CBSC and KUK for Kurukshetra University. The year of passing. Then comes the division and the marks obtained. Then the medium of instruction, that is English. In case people who have studied in Hindi, they can also write Hindi. Then boarder or day scholar. By boarder I mean those people who have been staying in hostels. And day boarder means those people who are communicating every day from their home to their college of education. Then outstanding achievement. Now in this particular column it is very important to understand that outstanding achievement is only related to your achievement in academics, applicable in all these three institutions. So now we turn over to the next page. So the eighth column contains information regarding age. Now as it has already been written, that information has to be written year and months. So 22 and 10, that is 22 years and 10 months. The next is height in meters. So there is no need to write the unit again. Weight in kilograms. So there is again no need to write the unit. Present occupation and personal monthly income. So in this case it is student. If you are pursuing a job, then you can write working in so and so company and your present monthly income. NCC training, this particular candidate did not receive any NCC training, so he has taken no, and the next column is not applicable to him, so he has entered the detail N/A, that is not applicable, and a dash is put in these three columns which are not applicable to him. Next comes the participation in games and sports. In games, he has participated in volleyball. Now duration of participation, there are two ways of writing it. Either you can mention from which year to which year you have participated, or you can mention 6 years. But the better way is to write from which year to which year. And representation at which level, school, college, university or any other level. Like in some private club, or you have your own team and freelance participation in sports event. Now outstanding achievement. In this case, it has won at inter-school tournament. Next comes a very important part, that is a part of hobbies and interests. Now gentlemen, hobbies are your pastimes and interests are something that you like doing, but it is not a hobby, that you like it. If it happens, then you are doing it. It does not happen like watching some kind of sport can be one form of interest. Watching some crime series can be another. Hobbies are something that is pastime that you do almost not regularly, but yes, during your free time. Next column is related to participation extracurricular activities which have taken place till now. Like in this case, inter-school debate, that was duration of participation, it was in the year 2012, and outstanding achievement in the same. The next column is position of responsibility, oblique offices held in NCC, scouting, sports team, extracurricular group and other fields. So in this case it is vice captain Shivagi House, class representative in college. So position of responsibility, any important position that was held by you which projects your responsibility, responsible behavior. Next comes nature of commission, which is whether permanent commission or short service commission. In this case the particular candidate is appearing for permanent commission. And choice of service, that is whether Army, Navy or Air Force. In this case it is Army. Number of chances availed in all three services, that means how many times have you appeared for SSB. Although there are certain instructions at certain Air Force boards where you are supposed to write how many times you have given the written examination. That is what they consider as your chance being availed. Next question, the next particular column is only related to those people who are repeaters. For them, you have to mention the information about the previous SSB. Now, it is very important that you know the information about your previous SSB and you mention it very correctly here. So with this I conclude the PIQ, and now let us talk in a general way. If you commit some kind of error during the filling of PIQ, like in this particular column, you can just put a slash on it, but avoid committing errors. You can also beforehand fill a PIQ form and carry it to the SSB center so that you fill the PIQ in the same way. You have to be constant in filling this information. Do not make any discrepancies or contradictions. Like there are three forms, so in one form you write something, in the other you write something else. Do not do that. Now the interview is conducted based on the PIQ. So every column that you are filling, you should have sufficient information about that particular column. And the questions will be related to the PIQ itself. The PIQ is also taken up by the psychologist, and he sees how much exposure you have got in life and thereby making out a personality of you, because he never sees you in person. So with that, I conclude this particular chapter regarding the PIQ. If there are any doubts or any queries, you can mention it in the comment section and we will revert you as soon as possible. Jai Hind.